We're asked to find the exact value of tangent of 5 pi divided by 12 radians. Because 5 pi divided by 12 radians is not a multiple of pi divided by 6 or pi divided by 4 radians, or a multiple of 30 or 45 degrees, we'll have to use the sum and difference identity for tangent to determine the exact value. And the sum and difference identity for a tangent is shown here below. The first step is to find two angles that are multiples of pi divided by 6 or pi divided by 4, or 30 degrees and 45 degrees, that have a sum or difference equal to 5 pi divided by 12 radians, which we can see below equals 75 degrees. So it may be helpful to convert to degrees, use degrees, and then convert back to radians. Probably the two most obvious angles we can use would be 45 degrees plus 30 degrees, which of course has a sum of 75 degrees, or in radians we'd have pi divided by 4 plus pi divided by 6 equals 5 pi divided by 12. This is probably the best choice for the two angles because both angles are in the first quadrant where we know all the trig functions are positive, which indicates we would not have to sketch the reference triangles to make sure we have the correct sign for the trig function values. We can simply use the reference triangles below. But that's not the only option we have. We could also use, for example, 120 degrees minus 45 degrees, which is equal to 75 degrees. Or in radians, because pi divided by 3 is 60 degrees, 120 degrees equals 2 pi divided by 3 radians minus pi divided by 4 radians, which would still give us 5 pi divided by 12 radians. But again, we'll go ahead and use the sum of pi divided by 4 and pi divided by 6. To begin to set this up, we have the tangent of 5 pi divided by 12 equals the tangent of, again, pi divided by 4 plus pi divided by 6. And now we apply the sum identity for the tangent function shown below. Because we have a sum on the left, we'll be using the top sign on the right, which means we have a sum in the numerator and a difference in the denominator. We have the tangent of the first angle of pi divided by 4 plus the tangent of the second angle of pi divided by 6. This is all divided by 1 minus the product of tangent pi divided by 4 and tangent pi divided by 6. And now we'll find the trig function values. Using the 45, 45, 90 reference triangle, or the pi divided by 4, pi divided by 4 reference triangle, the tangent of pi divided by 4 equals the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, which is 1 divided by 1, or 1, which gives us 1 plus tangent of pi divided by 6, again equals the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side, which is 1 divided by square root 3. In the denominator, we have 1 minus the product of tangent pi divided by 4, which is 1, and tangent pi divided by 6, which is 1 divided by square root 3. Simplifying, we have 1 plus 1 divided by square root 3, all divided by 1 minus 1 divided by square root 3. Let's clear the square root 3 from the denominators by multiplying the numerator and denominator of the complex fraction by square root 3. In the numerator, we have square root 3 times 1, which is square root 3, and then plus square root 3 times 1 divided by square root 3 equals 1, divided by, in the denominator, square root 3 times 1 is square root 3, and then minus square root 3 times 1 divided by square root 3, which is 1. This is perfectly fine for the exact value of the tangent of 5 pi divided by 12, but I also want to show the value if we rationalize the denominator. To rationalize the denominator, we multiply the numerator and denominator by the conjugate of the denominator. The conjugate of the square root of 3 minus 1 is the square root of 3 plus 1. So starting with the given expression, we would multiply the numerator and denominator by the square root of 3 plus 1. And we have four products in the numerator and denominator. Multiplying in the numerator, we have square root 3 times square root 3, which is 3. And then we have plus square root 3 times 1, which is square root 3. And then we have plus 1 times square root 3, which is another square root 3, giving us plus 2 square root 3. And then plus 1 times 1, which gives us plus 1. In the denominator, we have square root 3 times square root 3, which is 3. The next two products will be opposites. Square root 3 times 1 is positive square root 3. And then we have negative 1 times square root 3, which is negative square root 3. Those two terms simplify out. And then we have negative 1 times positive 1, which gives us minus 1. Simplifying, we have 4 plus 2 square root 3, all divided by 2, which is equal to 4 divided by 2 plus 2 square root 3 divided by 2. Simplifying, we can write the value of tangent 5 pi divided by 12 as 2 plus square root 3. Again, this form is normally not required, but just in case it is, we now know how to rationalize the denominator. I hope you found this helpful.